Om Namah Shivaya children, the topic we will begin with in this video is debugging. Now debugging, bug means errors. Now due to errors, a program may not execute or may generate wrong output. Okay. Now there are three types of errors that we will learn: syntax errors, logical errors and runtime errors. So let us read those in details. First is syntax errors. Now syntax, already while we were learning the chapter in the previous videos also, you've seen the syntax for input, for output. So there is a certain way of writing any programming language or any program. So in Python also there are rules. Python has rules that determine how a program is to be written. So that is called the syntax of how you're writing the program. This is called the syntax. So the interpreter can interpret a statement of a program only if it is syntactically correct. That is the interpreter, the Python interpreter, where you will type the program, that will give you a proper output only if there is, if you write it in a proper way, the syntax, you follow the proper syntax. Like for example, parenthesis must be in pairs. That is, if you open a parenthesis, it has to be closed. But if over here, see 7 plus 11, you've opened the parenthesis but not closed, because now due to the absence of right parenthesis, it won't give you the proper output. It will show you as a syntax error. If any syntax error is present, the interpreter shows the error message and stops the execution there. So in order to get the proper output, you have to write the program in a proper way or follow a proper syntax. Now next is logical error. Now a logical error is also called a bug. It is called a semantic error. It does not stop execution, but the program behaves incorrectly and produces undesired or wrong output. Now what happens in logical errors? Logical errors, even if the syntax is correct, but if the user does not understand the logic. Suppose you want to do addition, but you have written the minus sign you've written. So what will it give? The desired output won't come. So that is where it is called a logical error. Even if the syntax is correct, but there is a logical error or understanding error, it is called a bug or a semantic error also. In that case, it won't produce the correct output. It will give an output, but it will not give the correct or desired output. So that is where it is called the logical error. For example, if we wish to find the average of two numbers, 10 and 12, we write the code 10 plus 12 by 2. It would run successfully, but it will produce result 16, which is wrong, because you have written a wrong logic. The logic should be 10 plus 12 in brackets divided by 2, which will give the right output as 11. So this is the example of logical error. Last one is runtime error. Runtime error causes abnormal termination of program while it is executing. What happens? Runtime error is when the statement is correct syntactically, but the interpreter cannot execute it. The example will be like, for example, we have a statement having a division operator in the program. Say there's a division that you're trying to do, and after the division it comes to a zero. If the denominator value is zero, denominator zero, you know mathematically also denominator zero is wrong. So in that case it will give a runtime error like division by zero. You all know mathematically the division by zero is a error, but division sign is proper, so syntax is correct, but since division by zero is mathematically wrong, that's why it will come as a runtime error, or it will just terminate. So such case where the program, while it is executing, it terminates abnormally, in that case it is called a runtime error. Now the process of identifying and removing logical errors and runtime errors is called debugging. Okay, now so you have to, before you get the right output, you need to, one needs to remove the errors, logical errors, runtime errors, and also syntactic error should be corrected. So this process of identifying and removing the errors is called the debugging. We need to debug a program so that it can run successfully and generate the desired output. So you have learned what are the three types of errors that can occur in Python programming. Why Python programming? This kind of error occurs in any kind of programming language. Please learn the errors and also memorize the examples or understand the example so that the concept of errors is clear to you. In the next video, we will start with functions. Namaste.